6 billion honeybees' lives ended on August 29th, 2019, which started a chain reaction. Mad chicken disease plagued the human race. Everyone was 5 degrees too hot or too cold. And a robot dog was elected president of the United Nations of Sony. The resistance was able to send a lone warrior to go back to 2019 to save the human race. His name?
2 Chainz. Welcome to Most Expensivest. I am your host, 2 Chainz. And today we are here in the Bay, AKA San Francisco, that's right. You will follow me as I go check out this $110 million lab and learn how they plan on ending world hunger.
Without causing death, we can create actual animal meat.
And next we'll check out Amber, thermostat that's on your wrist so everybody can be comfortable at one time.
It's triggering your body's temperature response.
It's triggering your brain.
And we also sat down with Cheryl, who's with Sony, who had a bunch of neat gadgets and robots.
He's gonna love you. He builds emotions over time. He makes connections with you.
We can't talk about the future until we talk about the future of another species. That's right, bees. Everybody needs a little honey in their life.
They don't bite you.
They don't bite. They could sting, though.
So put your seatbelts on. We're riding in spaceships today. Most expensive is future, Jetson style.
By 2050, the Earth's population will grow by a third. That's 2 billion people, and they all need to eat. Problem is, meat production is unsustainable. It's depleting vital resources like energy, land, and water at an alarming rate, and it's contributing to global warming. Luckily, the nerds over at Just found a way to feed the world by turning plants into protein. The clock is ticking on our future, and it's time for 2 Chainz to take a bite.
Hey, how you doing? 2 Chainz.
Hey, Udi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you,
Udi. Thank you.
Tell the people some of what you have going on here.
We want to make the food system more sustainable, more healthy, and more just. So it's my job to find plants that we can put through our research system and develop really incredible new food products. It's pretty limited in the United States.
They got some plants up in Humboldt County.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's an incredible thing what hemp can do. It replaces Parmesan cheese.
Now, I see you got condiments over here.
Yep. So we found that actually certain plants do a really good job of emulsifying, just like an egg might, but in a way that's way more sustainable.
Ooh la la.
We've invested a lot of good resources into building robots, basically.
Real robots?
Real robots, yeah, just right over there.
Right now? I want to see the robots.
Yeah, we can go check out the robots.
They in here?
They are in this building. Yep.
2 Chainz.
Chunyao,
nice to meet you. Nice to meet you as well, man.
Nice to meet you.
So tell me what you got here. I heard a lot about the robots.
Yes, we source more than 300 different plant protein, and then we bring it up here to understand the, we call it protein functionality.
Okay.
It's been designed to actually study how protein gel, like scramble.
Oh.
So you see the right-hand side? Her name is Heidi.
Hello, I am Heidi. What up, Tim?
Wow.
And I'm gonna show you the automatic workflow, and you can see how the robots moves. You ready?
Yes.
All right.
We could
make it move then.
Oh.
Yes, that way. And you can see how the robots moves.
Oh.
Yeah, that way.
I'm on.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Wow.
That way.
Yeah.
Heard a lot about the robots.
Oh. Yes, that way.
What up?
Oh. Does Heidi have any sisters?
Actually, brother. So the instrument just behind you called Randy, which is named Randy Johnson, the big units, is actually doing an experiment too. It's helping to study how the protein may behave like butter.
Extra garlic butter. I got Benihana issues.
Good one, Randy.
Hey, man, I tell you, this was one hell of a roller coaster.
Thank you.
I'm super excited about the future.
Thank you.
I'm super excited about Heidi.
Thank you.
I appreciate the opportunity.
Thank you.
This place is crazy. How you doing, man?
Doing well.
Chainz, man.
Thomas.
Nice to meet you, Thomas.
I'm like 60% scientist, 40% chef. We have just egg right here, but this egg didn't come from a chicken. It came from a mung bean. And then we have some chorizo made from chicken, except we didn't have to kill a chicken to make this chorizo. So we actually take cells from an actual chicken, and we make them think that they're inside the chicken growing without causing death. We can create actual meat. So we're gonna get started on this omelet here.
Is that real butter?
Or do I have anything that's real? And this is from a bean.
It's from a bean?
Some of the just chicken chorizo. There we have it. Jump in. Have a mung bean just egg with cultured chicken chorizo.
Kind of just dissolve in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't getting to chew it.
Does it taste like an egg?
It's close.
It's close?
It's close.
So here we have this special salt. It's called Kalam Namak salt. So it's a sulfur salt. That's one of the main flavor components in egg. Perfect.
Yeah, Salt Bay, don't try to take that one.
Chainz Bay. Right now, we're really working to get the cost down to where we can be on par with the conventional that's out there. You ready for some fried chicken?
I guess so.
And I'll go grab it.
Good boy.
These people are gonna get rid of everybody before it's all over.
You ready for some fried chicken?
I guess so.
And I'll go grab it.
Boy, they're cloning some chickens in there.
All right, and here we have our just chicken bites. This is cultured chicken from the lab, fried up with one of our dressings made from the yellow pea. That's our chipotle ranch.
None of it real.
I mean, it's real.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You guys are real geniuses, right?
There's a lot of smart people. Josh is going to come in and try these.
Two Chainz, good to see you, man.
You are Just?
I'm the CEO and founder of Just. You need to taste the chicken, but I want you to understand, this chicken is not dead.
What you mean, man?
So the chicken that you're about to eat is not dead, because why do you have to kill it?
So where did you get this fancy idea from?
I grew up in Alabama. I think you grew
what
up
part?
Birmingham.
Got the Galleria Mall in Birmingham.
You know the Galleria Mall. I used to eat at Chick-fil-A in the Galleria Mall. My family was pretty poor growing
eating
up.
Eating Chick-fil-A, you was poor.
Once
Black
a week.
And white poor is two different things. All right, go ahead, though. So I see, man. You went through a lot.
And it's hard for regular people to eat good food. So I started to think, all right, we're going to use food to try to make meaningful change in the world.
Change the world.
We've raised about $250 million along the way.
Wow. Are we talking most expensive?
Everyone from Jerry Yang, Mark Benioff, the wealthiest person in Asia, Li Ka-shing, Heineken founding, early investors in Facebook, investors in this chicken.
I mean, how does that make you feel?
It makes me feel like I want you to like that chicken most of all. You mind if I eat it along with you?
Go ahead.
Okay. You know, capitalism can be used to do a lot of bad things, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you approach it in the right way, it can be used to help. I'm good.
Yeah.
Can be used to help people eat better all around the world.
Wow. What's the cost of some of this stuff?
The mayo right here is $3.49.
Okay.
Now, the meat that doesn't require killing a chicken is a little bit more expensive.
You taxing for that?
It's in the hundreds or thousands of dollars right now.
For what?
For the chicken. Oh, why does it cost so much money?
Yeah.
So it's a pretty complex process.
Got
it. We're in early stages. We're just making a little bit of it. Eventually, we want to get it below the cost of chicken.
I love it.
That's it.
I love it.
Most Expensivest Future. One day you're gonna be eating air. And you're gonna love it. From a plant, and everybody gonna be full.
Chainz, thank you, man. Appreciate it. Thanks for everything.
What up, what up? It's your player partner checking in again. Chainz, Most Expensivest. It's the futuristic part. And we out here in San Francisco, Silicon Valley. And you know they mixing the tech with everything else. So I got my road dog with me, Trappy. Trappy, speak to the people. That's right. And we're here with Miss Cheryl from Sony. And so tell me what you got going on.
Oh, there's so much going on. And let me just say that I'm happy to be here to tell you about it, because you're right. We're here in Silicon Valley, and this is where all the baddest stuff is happening. So when people think of Sony, they think of all these great cameras, TVs, audio products, which we do have.
Sony,
you know. Global domination, 130,000 employees. This is the culmination of a lot of hard work.
Is this a dog?
It's a dog. This dog's name is Aibo. And Aibo stands for AI bot. We were the first people talking about AI, artificial intelligence, and robotics, okay? So
this is for kids?
This is for kids. This dog, when you see him come alive, and he is alive, he's more human than humans, I know. He's gonna love you. He builds emotions over time. He makes connections with you. This is an evolving life form. And I use the word life form aggressively.
What you think, Trap? What you think, Trap? Trappy, now you are my everything, Trappy. But you do not sing to me.
Good boy.
These people are gonna get rid of everybody before it's all over. Okay, so how much is Aibo again?
So Aibo is $2,899.99. Did I get that 99 cents in there?
Yeah. All right. This is the most expensivest future, and in the future, I can see it's gonna be robotic dogs that don't pee or shit or bark. Unless told to. And then people are gonna stop buying really expensive watches and all right, maybe that's going far.
Yes.
I appreciate this slight learning lesson on robotics. Chainz. It's a watch.
Trust me, I went to MIT.
Oh.
So there's like a warming sensation.
Oh,
sort
man,
of relax. That robot dog, man, leaves a mess.
Y'all ready for the boy? What you got going on today? Amber.
Yeah, man, we're gonna talk about temperature.
Amber Wave. It's a watch, so to speak, or a bracelet.
We call it a feelable, because it changes how you feel. You control if you want it to warm up or cool down. And what we found is just changing the temperature of this one spot on your wrist can make you feel 5 degrees more comfortable in a room. Basically, having a hot tub on my wrist is a better way to go through life.
Right.
So like right now in this room, are you feeling warm? Are you feeling cold? You got an extra layer on?
I'm always cool.
You're always cool.
Hey, what's cooler than being cold?
Ice cold.
Ice cold.
Well said.
Are you already selling these?
Yeah,
are they
we
on
are.
The market?
Yeah. Everyone is affected by temperature.
Gotcha.
How we actually started working on the company was my co-founders and I were doing a project at MIT, doing some research, and we came up with the idea because we were in a over-air-conditioned lab. So we said, what if we could just heat and cool ourselves directly? In fact, it took us 3.5 years because it turns out temperature is pretty complicated. Our component that's doing the heating and cooling, when we first got it, it was something like this.
Oh, big face rolling.
It's
big,
huge. Big, so I'm gonna connect
you,
it to the back.
You hold it first. Now.
I'll hold it first. All right, I'm gonna tell you what I'm holding.
You're gonna shock the hell out of me up here on TV.
I got you. Don't worry. It's all safe. Yeah. Yeah, trust me. I went to MIT. Oh. So you'll feel one side gets hot, one side gets cold.
TRAP. Okay, I feel one side is definitely cool.
Yeah, one side's hot. And what's crazy is there's no moving parts in there. You think about an air conditioner or a fridge, and it's normally huge to make something hot or cold. This thing's just a little tight.
I'm definitely got to get my mom one.
You should.
She be having them flashes.
Gross. So I'm gonna put it on the inside of your wrist. And
it's kind of cool already, man.
Thank you. Well,
not like
the feels
temperature,
cool.
Yeah.
So you can adjust it there, but then to wake it up and control it, you can do it through by pressing either the blue side for cooling or the red side for warming. You're gonna start to feel that the warmth is gonna come in waves. You can just kind of feel it for a sec. There's a warming sensation that sort of relaxes. So that's what's crazy. Our skin, unlike a thermometer, acclimates the temperature, so it doesn't feel as hot. For us, delivering the sensation in waves creates a stronger response on your skin, on your nervous system, and ultimately makes you feel better. So it's triggering your body's temperature response.
It's triggering your brain.
Yeah, man.
This is really cool.
The product has Bluetooth, so it's got an app, so I can actually control your device with my phone, too. And if you get one, you can control it with your phone.
So how much would a device like this cost?
We're on our website right now, emberwave.com, and the price is $299.
That's not bad. It'll make you feel comfortable.
Yeah, man.
What's next? Silicon Valley. Futuristic. Future, futuristic.
Yeah. Well,
future. This is some futuristic stuff going on in here. I tell you what, you got me so... I like that, man. Most expensive is futuristic.
Do you think it'd be possible to get a quick picture of you wearing it for us together?
We gotta do that, man. We gotta get a picture.
Can we get you right over here?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. No, I'm just going to get a quick one and share it after as well.
Hiệp 2. Hãy xem pha đá phạt này.